I am so excited for you to see today's video. Over the last 60 days, I've been traveling the country, taking lessons with the best coaches on the planet in search of the perfect forehand. And finally, I can bring back the coaching gold to you, and that's why I'm so excited. And today you're gonna get a great lesson, an awesome lesson with legendary coach Rick Macci, and he gave me maybe the most important tennis lesson of my life. And this has been one of the best experiences of my life. In fact, my love and passion for tennis right now is at an all-time high. It's through the roof because of this experience. And to think that it all started from a guy trolling my forehand on YouTube. That's right, about 3 months ago, I posted a forehand video on YouTube, and up until that point, you know what, I really didn't think much about my forehand. It was good enough to become a state champion, a top 100 nationally ranked junior, and a Division I college tennis player, but this guy said something that really got into my core, and it was the first time in my tennis playing and coaching life I actually felt old. I'm 46 now, and when people say things to date you, it kind of really gets under my skin. It doesn't feel good. Maybe you can relate to that. Anyway, at that point, I was at a crossroads. I could either just ignore it or do something about it. So I decided to accept the challenge, and I also created a vision that was much bigger than me. I said, you know what? If I can get the best coaches on the planet, I know that I will improve my forehand a lot because these coaches are amazing, and it will also bring your forehand to a new level so we can both upgrade our forehand together. And the guy who is numero uno on the list was Rick Macci. Rick Macci is coaching royalty. He is a USPTA Hall of Famer. He's developed the Williams sisters, Andy Roddick, Maria Sharapova, Jennifer Capriati, all who have huge forehands, by the way. And Rick is the guy who coined the ATP forehand. And I had worked with Rick through TennisCon, and he was amazing, and he helped me help you. TennisCon is all about helping you guys become better players where I get the best coaches on the planet. But this time, I needed Rick to help me. So what I decided to do is I wrote Rick an email. I wrote him an email, and I asked him to give me a private lesson. And I wake up the next morning at 6 a.m., I'm an early riser, but not earlier than Rick, and Rick has already written me back. And Rick says, yes, we can do it. We can do reconstructive surgery, Pete. I'm booked for the next 2 weeks. My lessons are $500 an hour. Ouch. But if you're up for that, let's do it. Bring your cameras and let's do this for everybody. And so right after I read that email, guess what I did? I booked a hotel room. A couple weeks later, I'm getting in a rental car, driving 10 hours down from Atlanta to Boca Raton, Florida. Get my hotel room. I wake up the next morning to, guess what? Pouring rain. And I am just so, you know how you always think, oh, everybody's against you. So I'm feeling like that. I'm having one of those kind of days. But for no good reason, because it's not a very good reason to drive to an outdoor tennis lesson in the pouring rain, I'm driving to my tennis lesson in the pouring rain. And as I'm driving, it's raining pretty hard, but it starts to rain a little less hard. But I still don't think I'm gonna get my lesson in. I think I've just wasted a lot of time and money. And I show up to the courts, and there is Rick Macci on the court, squeegeeing away. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is pretty awesome. So I walk out to the court, the sun opens up, and Rick smiles, shakes my hand, and says, get your rackets, dude, it's showtime. So literally what you're about to see, there is no warm-up. It's literally lights, camera, action, go. And I got one of the best lessons of my life. It was perfect from start to finish. So enjoy this lesson and make sure to take notes. You're gonna love it. All right, guys, this is a huge honor. I'm here with Rick Macci. I am ready to pop the popcorn. I'm ready to learn a better way. Rick, I've got an old school modern forehand. They keep calling it the modern forehand. It ain't modern anymore, is it?
No, it's not. It's evolving every day and it gets trickier every week.
Yeah, so I am getting older, and maybe it's just an ego thing. I do not want people looking at me going, that guy's got an old man forehand. I want you to save me before it's too late, and I think now's the time to do it.
Well, listen, I love challenges. It could be like an amazing challenge.
Yeah.
I'm all up for that. Also, you got to remember, if something works, that's the most important thing. But I think wanting to learn new things, you're never too old or too young to learn anything.
Yeah.
I did reconstructive surgery, believe it or not, a month ago, on the forehand on an 85-year-old guy. He couldn't believe it. He's had more lessons than anybody around the world. So I'm ready for the challenge.
All right, well, I am excited. Let's do this.
You got it. Okay, here we go, showtime. What I'd like to do, I just need a little better blueprint or roadmap exactly how you're hitting your forehand. You know, once I see what's going on, then we're gonna get a game plan, get under the hood, I'm gonna get you the ATP forehand.
Awesome.
Here we go. Okay, not bad, not bad. There's some potential here, I got something to work with. You're in the neighborhood. Okay, definitely in the neighborhood. Okay, couple more. I like it, I like it. A few more, it's all about the repetitions. Good, I like it, I like it. All right, timeout. Okay, let me explain a little bit about what's going on. First off, there's a lot to work with here. Obviously, good athlete, you've been around the block, you've played. The racket starting off is on the hitting side. So right off the bat, you know, I'm not working from something from outer space where someone has a giant loop and the racket goes to Canada, to California, up to Mexico and back to Georgia. So the backswing is manageable. It is on the hitting side. So I can see that you've studied this. You've gotten bits and pieces of kind of maybe stuff you saw that I've done or other people. So you do have the concept down.
Okay, great.
I'm telling you all the good things first before I go for the jugular.
You said okay. You're not hopeless. Go for the jugular, Nick. That's what I'm here for.
Okay, so no, you're on the hitting side of the body, which I like. The first thing I would address is not even a technical issue. There's five things I see right off the bat you got to do.
Okay.
Relax.
Yeah, I'm tired. I'm nervous.
Relax. Relax. Relax.
I don't know if I
can
do that.
If you can get number five, relax. Oh. Okay. And this is pretty much, Peter, this is the wild card with a lot of adults.
Yeah.
And trust me, we're gonna get deep into the forehand and I'm gonna go over every aspect of how this thing should work. But at the end of the day, if I can put the technique on a relaxed thoroughbred, that's a lot different than even a donkey.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So really at the end of the day, the relaxation plays such a big component with adults. Because adults hold the racket too tight.
I'm holding it too tight.
There's way too much tension in your game.
Yeah.
You know, and for me to give you an AK-47 instead of a little pea shooter, okay, you can have great technique.
Right, right.
But what if the person's tight?
Yeah.
And we all know in sports, football, baseball, basketball, tennis, you can have a great technique, but if you're tight, it's gonna diminish the racket speed, it's gonna diminish the ball velocity, the spin rate and everything.
Yeah.
So the biggest thing I can tell you to do is try not to try, because it's been my experience for adults is they try too hard. You know, you want someone to try hard, you want that competitive spirit, and you want someone to work hard. Mm-hmm. But sometimes when there's so much tension, it ruins everything.
Yeah.
And this is the art of the deal. To become the best you can be, you gotta be very intense and try hard, which I see that's in your wheelhouse, but you gotta be calm.
Yeah.
And when those two forces meet, then you optimize your ability. You play at the highest level. And that's what these guys at the top and ladies do. Very high arousal, very intense, but they're calm.
Ah.
Before I get into the stroke, I want you to try one more thing.
Okay.
After you hit the ball, and I'm not saying there's a wrong way or a right way, there's a better way. Your back foot, and this is what a lot of people don't understand. It's usually a cause and an effect. After you hit the ball, the back foot can come around or the hip can come around. It's a great teaching tool that I use, but because of this tension stuff that we talked about earlier, your back foot is coming around sometimes a little too soon. And from the scapula area or the shoulder blade area, I see this a lot with adults, and it's what we call your muscling ball. And I'll go back to the tension. Remember how I said you were too tight? I want you to hit 10 more balls. Keep your back foot back after you hit the ball.
Okay.
After you hit it. Even if it feels natural to bring it around, I want it back, and then we're gonna have a discussion.
Okay.
Hopefully you won't pull a hamstring or the lesson's gonna be over. Oh, here goes a hammy. Just drag your back foot like a golfer for now. That's all I want you to do. Some of the ball's a little wet. Had a little rain this morning, but the show goes on here. Oh, back foot. Bring it back. Yeah, you just got to keep it back. Keep it back. Just keep it back. Keep it back. Okay, two more. Just keep it back. Okay, one more. Keep it back. Okay, conference. Come in here, Peter. Conference. Okay, you can say whatever you want to say about that exercise. What I'm doing here, I haven't gotten to the technique yet. I'm already throwing out some corrective techniques for you or for other coaches or people to be in touch with, because they read something, they hear something, you know, and a lot of times it's more surface stuff, it's vanilla, and the things that I try to do is I can connect the dots and correct things and kind of expedite the learning curve. But just tell me what you felt other than different when I said keep the foot back and you hit a few.
Felt longer, I felt extension, and I also felt more relaxed, and I felt more power coming from here. Did I do good? Did I do good, coach?
You did great. We hadn't even started yet. We hadn't even started with this stroke yet. But already off the bat, see, before I jump into the ring, I it's like an assembly line. Whether I start at the person's feet or their head, I react accordingly to what I call the big ticket items. And these things have jumped out at me. I see Peter is pretty tight compared to, you know, what level he should be at, in my opinion, with the relaxation. And as a corrective technique, I'm not, as a matter of fact, yesterday I had some kid bring that right foot around just so he would pull, the body would pull the racket instead of him arm it. But Peter's doing it because of tension. Your scapula and shoulder blade were in there so early, the kinetic chain instead of leg, hip, shoulder, arm was kind of leg, hip, and then you threw the kitchen sink in there.
Okay.
So, but what's funny, I don't want you to do things because I say it. I don't want you, I want people to disagree, because then I keep talking and probing till they all agree. That's the way I work this thing. It's all going to work out. But you immediately, when we talked about the relaxation, you bought in.
Yeah.
What I'm going to do now is all technical from here on in. Let's go.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so here's the most important thing so you don't waste what you just learned. I knew after I took that lesson from Rick that that is the beginning of my forehand journey. Like Rick pointed out, I am intense and maybe work a little too hard to a fault, but I also know that hard work was one of the reasons I excelled at tennis. And I knew that if I just went out down there and just took a lesson from Rick, that that was going to be a waste of time and money. I'd literally be taking $1,000 and flushing it down the toilet. So what I did next is, guess what? I got more lessons. In fact, in video number two, you're gonna get a lesson from Dr. Mark Kovacs, who's a leader in sports science. He works with all the top American pros. And you're gonna get a lesson on how you can improve your forehand by up to 20 miles an hour in 30 minutes. It was pretty awesome. But I didn't stop there. I knew it was time to hit the practice court, to keep practicing, to keep learning, to keep working, to keep the momentum going. That's what this is all about. So that's what I did. And here's another cool thing. Remember how I said this is all about you. We actually have a member here at this club who is actually also a member of the Crunch Time Coaching family. He's a Next Level University elite student, and his name is Paul Ferris. And I grabbed Paul and I said, hey Paul, come out to the court and I'm gonna show you what I've been learning from Rick and all these other pros. So what I want you to do right now, so you can get excited, because you should totally be able to relate to this. Paul is totally passionate, he's obsessed with tennis, but he's also got a lot of room to grow and improve his forehand. And you're gonna see through the steps that I took, the processes I learned from Rick Macci, you're gonna see his forehand improve right in front of your eyes and what Paul had to think about it. All right, Paul, so I had a blast working out with you. Thank you so much for being my training buddy today. What did you think of today's experience?
I thought it was excellent. I thought the starting off with the warm-up, I thought that was very good because it loosened you up, especially throwing the medicine ball, get your hips and everybody and everything in the same warmed up so you don't get injured. I thought that the next drill with the pulling the towel and the with the stretch, that was good too because it loosened up your shoulder. And then when we went to hitting the balls, I thought that was good too because it actually showed where I was and then not using as much power but then using more rotation.
Yeah.
So then that was a big plus too.
Yeah. So I thought you were doing a great job on your rotation too. Did you feel some easy power doing that?
Yes. I mean, I'm a power player, so I usually hit the ball pretty hard. But then the harder I tried to hit it, things weren't going right. So then I just loosened up and slowed down and not used as much force, and then it started going in. So I thought it showed easy power instead of just using hard power.
Right. Instead of like muscling it, yep. You were just relaxing and you really crushed some balls.
Yes. Yes, I think when I relax more, I think if the balls went better. So I think that's what I got to get used to, is using that easy power, not trying to muscle it, just trying to use the technique and let the racket do the work.
Well, cool, man. I had a great time. Will you train with me tomorrow?
Oh, yeah. If I can get up tomorrow, I'll be here.
So if you guys are watching this and you can find a training buddy, whether it's, you know, your significant other or your best buddy, or even hiring a coach for an hour to go through this stuff with you, it'll be great.
Definitely well worth it, because the things that we went through today, I mean, with the rotations and everything, they're little techniques that will improve your game 100%.
I had a blast. Let's do it tomorrow.
Let's do it, man.
So if this has you as pumped up as I am, I want you to get really excited, because in about a week's time, you're going to be able to go through your own forehand journey with me. You're going to get access to all the videos, the lessons in their entirety, as well as all the drills and video analysis that I've been doing, and you're going to get to go on that journey with me. But right now, it's time for step one. I need to hear from you. This is super important. I want to know, if you could change one thing about your forehand, what would it be? What would you upgrade on your forehand if you could? If you had the right information, the right coaching, what's the one thing that you want to upgrade on your forehand? Now, believe it or not, just by commenting, this is starting off your own personal forehand journey, because it's taking action and it's really thinking about what you want and creating a vision. That's the way that things get done. And I'm going to be reading every single comment and replying with encouraging coaching advice. And plus, beyond that, you're going to get a chance. You're going to, just by commenting, you're entering a raffle to win a free wrist racket. A wrist racket is from on court, off court. It's one of the things that I use to really help me get that feeling of that snap, that lag and snap, which increases the racket at speed and increases the RPMs and the power. So by commenting, you're gonna get entered in the raffle to do that. So make sure you comment below and be looking out for video number two, to where I'm gonna show you how you can improve your forehand. Well, actually, Dr. Mark Kovacs is gonna show you how you can increase your forehand by 20 miles an hour, hit it 20 miles an hour faster in 30 minutes. It's gonna be awesome. Be looking in your inbox. Comment below right now so we can continue this conversation. I'll be looking for your comment and we'll be talking.